this particular project deals with asking the questions of what are the effects of this invasive shrub species, shrub honeysuckle, on the plants and soils of the park? And also, when managers decide to remove them wholesale, what are the implications for the return? Will we get species of plants that we want to return? Will there be temporary soil loss from removing a lot of shrubs? This project, which is funded by the EPA, is being done in partnership with the Louisville Olmsted Parks Conservancy, who have been really important in helping the research mission here. In 2008, we set up different locations in Cherokee and Seneca Park, where we put two plots side by side and studied them for a year, measured the plants, measured soil fertility and soil loss. And then, at the end of the first year, we flipped a coin, and one of those plots got cut, and all the honeysuckle was cut from it. We've been studying the response of the system, these systems in these plot areas, ever since then. Here's a great example of what honeysuckle can do to a young growing tree. This is a sugar maple tree trying to make it under a honeysuckle canopy, and you can see a lot of dead branches. It's really not doing very well. And it's an example of the fact that, you know, if you don't have baby trees and you don't have teenage trees, you're not going to have a future forest down the road. The students that are involved in this project not only gain valuable experience for their future careers, but they are invaluable and so important for this project. Without them, this project just couldn't happen. It's very labor-intensive work. What can concerned people do who live near these urban park woodlands? They should be more aware of what exactly they're planting in their yards. Are they invasive species? And there are many websites to which they can turn, and they can certainly contact me at UofL if they want to know.